I had the pleasure of meeting Alex several years ago, and now have the pleasure of working, partnering with her. Alex is a lifelong student of sexual health. She is the co-founder and CEO of Dame Products. She's a credentialed sexologist and a member of Forbes 30 Under 30 in 2018. She co-founded Dame Products to start necessary conversations, to listen rather than assume, and to create products that enhance intimacy. After earning her master's degree in clinical psychology with a concentration in sex therapy from Columbia, Alex decided to lend her passion and expertise to the world of sex tech. In just 5 years, Dame Products and its meticulously engineered vibrators have been met with critical and popular acclaim, earning praise in outlets including The New York Times, Forbes, Wired, BBC, and most recently, The Today Show. It's my pleasure to welcome Alex.
Hi. Hi. That was such a wonderful introduction. I am honored. I'm so excited to be here today. I am excited to tell you about not only my business, but some of the options and tools that we offer that I think can be really helpful for patients. And as well as, I think kind of to hit again on some of the gender gap, the issues that we face as a brand. I think it's kind of illuminating to see the challenges I have and how female sexuality is just not often taken as seriously as male sexuality. So I'm gonna share my screen. Oh, well, I hope everybody is having a wonderful day, and I invite you to start off with me by just taking a deep breath together so we can kind of maybe release the day and get a little present here. So let's all take a deep breath in through our nose and then just sigh it all out. Ah, I'm going to do it one more time because I think it feels so good. So, ah. All right, I'm here now. Okay, so sex is a powerful, universal experience. It is literally how we all exist. It is often a part of our most powerful connections and interpersonal relationships, and it can often define our worst moments, our most traumatic experiences. And I think that really speaks to the power it has in our overall well-being. Dr. Jafade was just talking about like how we shouldn't have to pick between our mental well-being and our sexual well-being. And the truth is too, we shouldn't have to pick because they end up being so tied together as well. So it's clearly this vital part of our identities, of our psychology. Yet we do very, very little to improve it. In fact, we hardly talk about it and we are confused by it and we are taught that it's really, really, really bad and icky, but you better be good at it or else you won't find a partner. So there's not a lot of confusing messages around there, and that's exactly where Dame comes in. We believe that healthy sex should feel good. And we create tools, products, and content to help it feel good. I will say really quickly on this slide that this feels like can feel like an obvious statement, but again, like Dr. Jermaine was just talking about, 75% of women experience painful sex at some point during their lives. So many women are told that they're just supposed to lie there and take it, that is part of their narrative, that having sex for the first time is going to hurt. In fact, I think I tried to run a campaign with this messaging and I had some men be like, well, everybody knows that already. I'm like, you know what? People, not everybody does know this. And this is something that we should educate around. Healthy sex should feel good. I think it should also feel good afterwards, mentally. And wow, you can really tell when I have that blue screen on my face, can't you? Fun. So Yeah, so we're Dame Products and we are practicing pleasure. We make pleasure practices. We're cultivating pleasure to enrich health by thoughtfully designing tools, spaces, and resources for intimacy. This here is on the left side of the screen is our newest product, Air. This is actually the only time you're gonna see a photo of it, so I'm just gonna touch on it really quickly. It is a suction product that uses airflow to stimulate the clitoris in a really direct way. And it really does help. I think all vibration is gonna help create blood flow in the clitoris, but this product in particular uses an oscillating motor to push air back and forth, creating some suction feels, which can not only help with pleasure, but really can help with arousal, which of course is a main challenge that a lot of people with vulvas have. But yeah, so that's that product. So this is me with bangs and my co-founder Janet in a silly video. But we started the business back in 2014 with the idea of closing this pleasure gap. Women are 4 times more likely than men to say that sex has been not at all pleasurable in the past year. And I think, you know, we could talk about the orgasm gap, but I think that that's a really male-centric way of even viewing sexuality. I don't think orgasm is the only way we can enjoy sex, but it is certainly something I think people deserve and a wonderful experience. But women are 4 times more likely than men to say that sex has been not at all pleasurable in the past year. And I think that that subjective experience of what sex is part of why 10% of women are experiencing HSDD. So yeah, that's what we came together to do as when I was introduced, saying I have my master's in clinical psychology from Columbia. I went to WashU in St. Louis before that, and I got my master's in clinical psych. I went to undergrad for like psych, women, gender studies, art, and business. And my mom was like, what are you doing with all those things? They don't go together. But little did she know, I was going to start a sexual wellness company one day and make them all go together. My co-founder, Janet Lieberman, went to MIT for mechanical engineering. She's actually no longer working at the company, but we started this business together and with the idea that with smart female engineers and sex educators, and now we'll talk a little bit about this in a second, developing a clinical board of more sex experts, we can create tools that help close that pleasure gap. I don't think we are only helping people with vulvas. I do think, you know, a lot of my favorite reviews are from partners who feel disconnected and buy one of our products and it changes their relationship with their partner. And it's a profound experience for them as well. I'm sure Emily from Onut will also kind of speak to that experience. We started off crowdfunding. So our first product, Eva, is a hands-free clitoral vibrator that can be worn during sex. And I'll show you guys a little video on exactly how that works in a little bit. But we had this really wild idea that we can make a vibrator stay in place and provide clitoral stimulation, which, you know, different research has different stats around this, but some research has 70 to 80% of women, the only way they can experience an orgasm is through clitoral stimulation. I think one of my favorite stats around this is from a researcher named Dr. Lori Mintz, who says that her research showed that only 4% of women report penetration as the most reliable route to orgasm. And I love that stat because that means 96% of women, when they want to have an orgasm, they are relying on some type of additional stimulation besides just penetration, usually as external stimulation on their clitoris, that's gonna help them achieve climax. So we wanted to create a product that gave clitoral stimulation in a way that doesn't block the vaginal opening and can be worn hands-free. Our product, this idea It raised actually $575,000 in 45 days. I know it says 846, but that's because like it just kept going after like the crowdfunding campaign ended. And I took a screenshot like a year later and it just kept on going up. But, you know, I think we had about 6,000 pre-orders. And I mean, it was just truly profound to have so many customers, so many people come and show up and say, we are interested in this product. This makes so much sense to us. We're looking for it. We're going to trust these crazy 20-something-year-old girls to make it. And I think that that also kind of cemented for us the power and the most important thing that we do is developing community. We were able to make this toy. It started off with, I just had some friends come over and try out these handmade vibrators that I had made. And I'm so grateful for said friends for trying something out and giving me visual and written surveys and like telling me about their experience as well as showing me their experience so we can make this product truly work. And from there, we realized that like we just, community was going to be key. Listening to customers, understanding what really works, treating this like science and not like a taboo is how we can really make products that are better. All of our products are medical grade silicone, rechargeable, except for Z, which uses ABS plastic. And again, I'll talk a little bit about that in a second. Our second product, which is on the right below here, called Fin. It's a vibrator for fingers. This is a wearable vibrator that you can wear in your hand. This product is fantastic for anybody who wants to incorporate a vibrator more seamlessly into touch. This really came from a lot of partners saying they loved Eva, but they actually wanted to be more active. It also comes with a tether that you can't see in this photo that makes it really great for people with disabilities. I do want to just, you know, a lot of these tools are about enabling pleasure where we can. And we've definitely found that people with disabilities or chronic pain, they are so helpful in helping us develop toys that are ultimately useful for all. And it's a real privilege to be able to offer products that help people thrive and experience joy and pleasure in their lives. This product was the first toy ever allowed on the Kickstarter platform. And I'm just going to mention that because I think so much of what we do is about, you know, taking these valuable products that make a difference in people's overall well-being and health, taking them out of the shameful, seedy world of pornography, of XXX shops, and replacing them in where they actually originally started, which is in more of a medical community, in the wellness space. It actually wasn't until the 60s that due to laws, they kind of got moved from this one industry to another industry. And so people are like, oh, you're changing it. I'm like, I'm kind of replacing it to where it originally was. Anyway, so, you know, about getting people to take this category seriously, to respect it, and to give it the validation that we often give to male products. And yeah, this is also, I'm not gonna watch this video right now, but I will circulate it later. This is me and my co-founder Janet on the Megyn Kelly Today Show. And while I think there's lots of mixed feelings about Megyn Kelly, I will say she saw us as business entrepreneurs taking on an important topic and put us on her show, which was really powerful for our business and something that so often we don't get the opportunity to do. And I got to say clitoris on national TV, which I think is something I'm really proud of. Oh, we're not going to do that. All right, so here is an animation of our first toy, Eva. This is Eva, and I just wanted to take a moment just to explain how it has these bendable wings that tuck underneath the labia, and it kind of puts a little bit of pressure outside, and that little bit of pressure keeps it in place, and you can wear it while you're having sex. This part's just showing you how it gets charged, But overall, we think it's a pretty cute video, and also speaks to kind of like the way we design our products. So in general, we make toys for sex. We also have a all natural lubricant called Alu. And watch out, we're coming out with some more products that do help increase blood flow to the vulva and help with arousal in general. And I just wanted to take a moment here to walk you guys through some of our products so you have a sense of some of the tools that we've created that may or may not be helpful for your customers. So we have Alu, which is here on the left. It's an all natural lubricant using aloe vera juice as its main component. It's nice and slippery, and it's also water-based, which is great for condoms and use with sex toys. Then you have Kip, which is the one, both the yellow and purple product here. This product is designed to be really ergonomic to hold. So it has this triangle shape, and that triangle shape, we actually modeled it based off of ergonomic pencils. So pencils that have been designed for people who have mobility issues. So it makes it really easy to hold, has a nice flutter feature, and is great for clitoral stimulation. And then here is Finn, that finger vibrator that I was talking about, but here you can see it with the tether on, and you can see how that kind of ties onto your fingers and makes it really easy to hold and play with your partner. And then this other product behind it in jade, or in that light green blue color, is Palm. Palm is my personal favorite, if that's not too much information for you. It's squishy, it bends a little bit. I literally have three, usually one somewhere lost in my bed. I absolutely love this toy. It is got a nice broad stimulation, and since it bends, it moves with your body. So I think that's a real treat to use. It's also great for couples play. And then all the way here on the right, and then you see Eva, and then all the way on the right is Arc, which is our internal toy. Something really interesting about this toy is in our development, what we found was that 85% of people who buy internal toys are using them externally too. And often they use them to kind of warm up. So we wanted to really design a product that provided external stimulation as well as internal stimulation and internal pressure. So you can learn more about your vaginal wall and what parts of your vagina feel good to add some additional pressure to. Again, all of our products here are medical grade silicone. They're rechargeable. We design them to have a multitude of patterns depending on the product. And also you can kind of see how some of them, they have a raised bump, and that raised bump helps you know which way is up and which way is down when you're not looking at the product. And I think those are some of like the simple innovations that we've been able to create by just talking to customers. And also being customers ourselves. So, you know, I think oftentimes when we see this gender divide, a big thing is that, you know, women haven't been in positions of power. They're not part of the design team. And that can often lead to just like a lot of, honestly, it's led for a lot of opportunity for us. There's some simple design decisions where it's like, yeah, you don't look at you can't see the toy when you're using it. Like anybody who just, you know, uses the toy would know that. So we were able to design to create like a very smart innovation that we think consumers really love, just because nobody had thought of that before. We use 3D printers in-house to do all of our prototyping, and our design process starts first and foremost with our customers. We have a community called Dame Labs, and that's usually where we get almost all of our ideas, simply by asking questions and listening to their answers. What is it that you're looking for? What are your pain points? And learning more, again, just by empathizing and listening to them. We also have been creating a clinical board, which we're really excited about, to incorporate doctors in a more formal way in our design process. We've worked in the past with sex therapists and want to have a more formalized way that we're working with them. So they're now going to be a part of our brainstorming sessions from the beginning, as well as evaluating the product as we go down our development process. Again, we prototype in-house, and then it kind of just goes through this iteration process. So we prototype in-house, We send them out to Dame Labs members who try them out, give us their feedback. We take that feedback, we tweak it, we send them out again until we feel like we've created a product that we are confident in, not only that we can manufacture it well, but that consumers are really going to enjoy. So here you can see a workshop of women who came together to talk about vibrators and what they like and what they don't like, and how we go about our design process. And also on the left here, you can see another product that we make called Pillow. Pillow is a body positioning pillow. It's very much like a yoga bolstering pillow, but we just designed it with sex in mind. These products have existed forever, but they often look like they belong in a dungeon, which is wild because they're one of the most commonly prescribed products by sex therapists. They can really help not only increase pleasure, but also decrease pain. So we just wanted to make one that didn't feel embarrassing, didn't feel like, you know, just by changing the aesthetic, we were able to create a really wonderful and effective product. It's another type of product we have. And I do feel like, I'm not gonna leave on that slide because it's blue. It's just another example of like talking to people about what they want and where the disconnect is. And also by just changing the aesthetic, changing this narrative. I can't tell you how many women have come up to me and have just said something to the effects of like, I knew vibrators existed, but I don't know why I had never really considered buying one until I've seen your brand. And I think that really speaks to like, yes, our products are innovative. Yes, our products, we like hold ourselves to a higher standard than an industry that doesn't have a lot of regulation. So I think we're offering better products. We have a 3-year warranty, a money back guarantee. Now we do store credit. So if you're unhappy, we'll try and find another product that makes you happy. But really it's also just about the positioning and the conversation that we're having around it that seems to help people who maybe were a little bit shy about trying something like this feel so much more comfortable doing it. We have 3 minutes left. So really quickly, I also just want to touch on some of our challenges. So we really struggled to advertise. We wanted to advertise with the MTA. They originally told us we could advertise, and after working with us for 6 months, decided that we couldn't advertise, saying that we were a sexually oriented company, and that they would never work with any sexually oriented brands. Meanwhile, not only are they using sex often in their other advertisements to sell products and breast enhancements being sold on the subway in New York, but also erectile dysfunction pills were being sold there were huge advertisements of like phallic cactuses. And it sparked a really, I think, important and healthy conversation around what makes that not sexual, but acknowledging sex toys sexual. They weren't able to give us a great answer. And actually now we're fighting the good fight in a lawsuit. And I think it really speaks to me the way we often believe that men's right to sex is part of their health, but women aren't entitled to the same level of sexual pleasure. And that as long as, you know, I think the idea generally comes down to like, well, men need erections, but women don't need pleasure. And I think that just sets us up for HSDD, for like all of these other issues that are both mental and psychological that impact our relationships, our well-being holistically. And that is exactly why, you know, I started this business, was to kind of change that narrative. So it has been a pleasure chatting with you. I'm Alex, I'm the CEO. You can reach out to me at alex@dameproducts.com. If you're interested in helping us create great products, or we do workshops, there's just so many ways that we like to engage. And we're always interested in learning more. And the company is Dame Products, and you can find it on all social media, pretty much at Dame Products. I'm also at A Fine Human, but you don't worry about me. I see that there's a Q&A. Is that, I would love if there's Can I answer questions?
Yes, yes. I wanted to ask, there is a Q&A. One of them you answered live, which is awesome already. But one of them is, if you knew someone wanting to begin making sex toys, would you recommend 3D printing prototypes? Or someone else, if someone wanted to impact sexual wellness for women through sex tech, where are the avenues moving forward in the future in this field, do you think?
Yeah, I mean, one, it has changed. It has been such an amazing ride. Like 6 years ago when I started this company, I literally had an investor ask me if it was a joke. I'm like, that was the response. And then in the past few months, we raised $4 million from institution, like from a real VC. So I think that really speaks to the way this like category has changed. People are really excited about it. So there is, and also like we're doing well, we're making money. And I think that that's another thing that investors are ultimately excited about. So all of that is wonderful. I would say if you really want to get involved in the sex tech community, there's definitely one, a community, like there's the Women of Sex Tech, there are places and people to chat with. You're welcome to just get in touch with me to discuss it. I think that whenever you want to go and make a physical product, it's all about, or digital product, it's about creating your MVP. It's about validating the need as much as you can before you start spending money. So go out there, do a survey, see if people are interested in this concept. And then like what I did before I met my co-founder who was an engineer, I literally just started taking apart other vibrators, wrapping them in moldable plastic that I found at an art supply store, and having friends and myself try that out to see if it worked. So you don't need to know how to 3D print to get started. It is a really great stepping stone, like step in the process if you want to do in-depth rapid prototyping to make the best product that you can. And there's so many other ways to just go out and get a product manufactured. But those are some of my suggestions.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Alex. That was great. We always love hearing from you and talking with you. And thank you for being a part of our night tonight.
Thank you. Thank you. And thank you guys so much. Obviously, Dr. Trevade has been so helpful for us in making our products, and we're excited about our continued partnership. All right.
Bye. Thank you. So I just wanted to take a moment right now to give a shout out to Myriad, who helped to sponsor this event for us, to help ensure that we could, you know, have this tonight. And Myriad's mission is to ensure every woman has access to what they're called transformative genetic insights. So they have genetic screening and tests that provide women with actionable information, empowering them and their families to make critical and timely healthcare decisions, whether they're thinking about starting a family or evaluating their risk for hereditary cancer. Their goal is to put patients first. So we do want to thank them for helping make tonight possible.